We shall now study how to use link with actual database rather than with the collection as we have been doing in the past. So for this, let us first of all get a database made, and then we will demonstrate how we can connect to the database from the very basic steps, that is without the taking any help of the designer. We'll be demonstrating like from the very fundamentals. Although in real practice you don't use that, but that will help you clarify some of the concepts. So let me now move on to creating a database. So follow these steps. Here is an app. You should have created a basic MVC application, and now we'll click on the app_data folder, add new item, and instead of SQL Server Compact we can do the fuller version also because we haven't done so far. So we can write SQL Server Database and we can give it any name. I am giving it DB users. So my general trend is to always start the name of database with the DB and click add. So after a while you'll find dbusers.mdf under app_data, and since it is under app_data we'll be easily seeing it _database_explorer, and here we can click, the database appears here. The connection is closed by default because of this red cross, and you can see then we can click it to open, and there is nothing under tables. You can have stored procedures and everything, that's empty basically. Let us now add one table. Right click on tables and click add new table. After a long time this one appears. The pane you see here is T-SQL, that is it actually represents the SQL equivalent of the diagram you are seeing here. So here we are seeing the SQL equivalent, create table dbo.table, the name of the table is table. This care bracket can be used to store names of your tables, but this care bracket is required in two cases compulsorily. You are welcome to store your table name as tbl name here like this, no issues. But even if you don't do in this case, it will work because there are no gaps. But if you are giving a name in which gaps are there, then you must use these care brackets. One case. The other case is when you are going to use a name that is same as a keyword. So if I see the scene below, table is actually a keyword. So it has been put inside this. The name of the table will be table, but it's absurd, we'll immediately change it. So don't forget to change this in your case. So we can change it here. This is the only place where you can change. I am giving it TBL users. So you must change this first. And now let us come. This is ID. I'll change it to email. And here I can choose nvarchar, just creating a table nvarchar 50, and this is primary key, but I can right click it to remove primary key, and if it is not there to set primary key. The trick is to right click, and then the next time writing name, this also I am quickly putting nvarchar 50, and allow nulls is, we don't allow nulls, no default is set. So we are creating a simple table for our demonstration purposes. Now how to store this table to a database. This is our database. This table doesn't appear here until we go and click this update. This update will be available just above this. Click on this and this story appears, and then we can click update database. And now to see, we can refresh this, refresh, and your table appears here. and both the columns are here. So you can see one interesting thing that I've written: create table TBL users. I changed the name. I changed the name from table to TBL users. If you don't do it, then the name will be table only. So many people commit that mistake, and even I used to commit that mistake. So you can avoid this. Next, now let us add the second table also. Add new table. Here also again we'll give it TBL orders, and come back to this one. Here I'm writing user ID, so I'll have to give it a running ID, so I'll keep it, I retain it. This ID I want to give it an auto numbered, so what I can do is right click properties. So in the properties they tend to disappear, you should pin them out from here. So I brought these properties into view. I'm hiding the database explorer, and these are the properties. So what I did is I right clicked here, properties, and inside properties there is an identity specification. I can set it to true. Increment is 1 and seed is 1. So this counting will this will auto number the columns. The first column will have a value of 1, the second will have a value of 2. So they will be automatically incremented. Then, because generally you should always have a primary key in your database table. Primary key is always recommended. Normally we have primary keys like email addresses, but if there is no that you can find, then at least you should add an auto numbered ID there, identity. Then next we can use is user ID foreign key, nvarchar 50, and here I'm using order number nvarchar 50, and I've quickly keyed down the table. So this will be, this user ID fk will actually be your foreign key from the earlier table. And now I'll update the database, update, and click on update database, come to database explorer, tables, refresh, and my TBL users and TBL orders is in place. I'm not creating those relationships, those foreign key, primary key relationships here to keep the things simple. Otherwise, if you want to create, then you have to write the property SQL code here and execute that. You can look up internet for the proper syntax. But in the meantime, I have created two tables, TBL orders and TBL users. I have actually put a user ID foreign key for the email, but I haven't created the relationships. I haven't created them formally, but still I'll honor them. So what I'll do is I'll start by adding some data, show table data. Here I can add one a@a.com, name is Hovan, b@b.com, name is India, just putting anything what comes to my mind, c@c.com, name is Google. Okay, I've added three entries to it, and now I'll quickly add some entries to the other table also, TBL orders. Show table data, and since this will be auto numbered, it's grayed out, I cannot type anything there. User ID foreign key. So here I'll write one order for a@a.com, order number is I can say 01, then another order for a.com 02, then I think I wrote B. Let me check up B and C. b@b.com, order is 03, then c@c.com, order is 04, and again one order for, let us say, c@c.com, order is 05. So basically I have added some data to both the tables, and we have quickly seen how to create tables. So summarizing, if you want, we can we right clicked this table, add new table, and the moment we got a thing like this, we changed this name quickly, and then we just set the data types and the keys, and primary keys also can be set by right clicking. And so that way we actually created. And then finally, how did we add data? We right clicked, show table data, and the moment we clicked it, an Excel like thing appeared and we added the records there one by one. The moment you push enter, the records get committed also. So in the next step, we'll proceed with the programming.